Hi friends, in renewable energy systems, solar energy basic concepts will be discussed in 4 to 5 or maybe 8 lectures in coming lectures. And this is the first lecture under solar energy, the basic concepts. First topic is introduction. Let us see how solar energy will be and what is the things and how we were, that means our ancestors were used solar energy, in which way they have used it and in which way they have survived in this solar system. So all these things will be discussed in this video. Let us first see the advantages of solar energy. What are the different advantages of solar energy? Yeah, actually the sun radiates the energy uniformly in all directions in the form of electromagnetic waves. Okay, so in some form the sun has radiated in electromagnetic waves. Let us see what is advantage of electromagnetic waves. Yeah, when it is absorbed by the body, it increases the temperature. So this is the great advantage of this solar energy. Yes, we need temperature for so many things. So if the solar energy was radiated on any body and the body has absorbed some energy, some radiant energy, definitely the temperature of the body increases, and that is, it can be converted into so many applications. So this is the major advantage of the solar energy. And let us see what is some other advantage. So it provides the energy to sustain life in our solar system. It will provide complete energy to sustain the life. That means if sun rays fallen on our body, some diseases may be gone off and some functionality in our body will be perfect. So all these are the advantages of the solar energy. And let us see one more thing. Yeah, it's clean. Obviously we know this, it's a clean energy, inexhaustible energy. There is no exhausting nature of this energy. It is abundantly available and universally available. So wherever you go, you will get more or less solar energy available. So a renewable energy system source. So this is these are the main advantages of the solar energy. And let us see the disadvantages of solar energy. The disadvantages are drawbacks. It's a dilute form of energy. Of course, we cannot get the concentrated energy of this form. It's a diluted form. So you need to collect it in a wide area. That means it requires a large area to collect the energy and to convert it into useful energy. We need to have large area to collect this energy, as this energy is very diluted energy, but we want concentrated energy. So to collect it, we have too much area is required. It is available intermittently. Obviously, intermittently means it is available. Sometimes it will be there and the other time it won't be there. Won't be. That means definitely it will not be there. That means in daytime energy will be there. At night time there is no energy. So that's why it is an intermittent energy. It is uncertain. That means we cannot predict accurately that tomorrow there will be a sun or not accurately. Okay. Of course, we can predict something. Maybe tomorrow may be rain, or tomorrow sun may not come. Some predictions may be there, but it's not uncertain. The energy is uncertain. It's not steady. Okay, we can't give guarantee that the sun rays may be increased in a uniform fashion up to the midday, and it is reduced in a uniform fashion up to the night. Okay, they may not, of course same thing happens, but exactly we cannot predict. So that's why it's not steady. Suddenly there may be some clouds, so the sun rays may come down. Okay, it's not continuous, as we know that it's an intermittent is different and it's not continuous is different. Intermittent means definitely 12 hours day and definitely 12 hours night. for example. That's the definite day. That means day and nights are definite. That is called intermittent. It's not continuous means maybe sometimes the cloud may come, sometimes something may happen. So all these things are come under not continuous. Okay, these are 2 points only. We can boldly say that they are 2 points. Okay, they are not single point. It's available intermittently is different, and it's not continuously different. But there is a little bit advantage compared to the other renewable source, that is wind energy. We can predict, the prediction may be more accurate compared to wind energy. So if you go ahead with renewable energy sources, and if you like to go like to erect solar energy and wind energy, you can predict solar energy better compared to the wind energy. Okay, that advantage is there with solar energy when compared to wind energy. So let's see the some other information. So peak solar insolation, so incident solar radiation often coincides with peak daytime demand. Of course, the people will work only in daytime because the sun is there. That's why that was a habituated thing for human beings. So in daytime we need to do work, and in, at night time we need to sleep. Okay, that depends upon the sun only, but still it come in the reverse order. So peak daytime demand. So in peak day, the that means in daytime the energy demand will be more. That means maybe the electrical demand will be more, power demand will be more, and that can be given by the solar energy efficiently, because in daytime only the solar energy is abundant and the, it is having a good form, and it can give you in a very good energy in daytime only. So it can easily be covered, and it can easily be handle the demand of the daytime. It can be well matched to the commercial power needs. That means suppose I have the commercial area, I can easily erect my solar energy, because the for commercial area the energy will be required in the daytime only. So in solar energy can also be given the energy in daytime only. So you both can be coincide. So I can easily take the solar energy in daytime, and I can easily use the solar energy in daytime itself. So that's why this energy is very suitable for the commercial needs. In the output of sun is 2.18 to 10 to the power of 28 kilowatt. And the energy reaching the earth is 1.5 into 10 to the power of 18 kilowatt hour per year. That means there is a approximately 10 to the power of 5 times energy will be lost while traveling from sun to earth. So that's what he is trying to say. So this is the other information from solar energy. Yeah, how can we utilize solar energy directly? So there are two types of utilization of the solar energy directly. That means the collecting the radiant heat and using it in a thermal system. That means we can collect the radiant energy, we can collect the heat energy from the radiant energy, and we can directly use it to the thermal systems. That means to heat up any device. That means maybe I can use it in solar water heaters, and I can use it in some other purposes too, where heating is required and where temperature rises are required. So that those systems are called solar thermal systems. And coming to the next part, so by collecting and converting it directly to electrical energy using photovoltaic system. So this is one of the famous systems. So the system is called solar photovoltaic system. That means the solar energy is directly converted into electrical energy, and then it will be used for so many things. So after that, you can say that different advantages of electrical energy to support your point. That means solar photovoltaic system. So these are the two direct utilizations of the solar energy. One is the solar thermal system, and second one is solar photovoltaic system. So this covers the entire syllabus, or this covers the entire discussion of the solar energy, where if you can able to study solar thermal systems, and if you can able to study solar photovoltaic system, that's sufficient for this solar energy study. And the next one is mother of all forms of energy. Solar energy. Mother of all forms of energy. Solar energy is the mother of all forms of energy because of the sun and because of the solar energy only, we are obtaining some other forms of energy. So let us see what are those forms of energy also. Yeah, the other sources of energy from sun or from because of solar energy is wind energy. So because of sun only there is a wind, and biomass energy, tidal energy, ocean wave energy, ocean thermal energy, fossil fuels and other organic chemicals. So everything will be done, all these things will be done by the this energy only, which solar energy only, or we can call it as just because of the sun. And coming to except the nuclear energy, all other forms of energy are based on the sun only. So we can call the solar energy as mother of all forms of energy, even hydro energy also. So let us see history. So how our ancestors and how our ancient people have used this solar energy. At start, they used it for the warming of the body during winter. Okay, this is the first use of solar, direct solar energy that man has made. That means man identified that there is some heat energy coming from the solar energy. So whenever we have winter, so we can go and expose our body to sun so that we can get heat. Okay, that thing was identified by the ancient people, and that was the first identification from the solar energy. And second one is in the drying of cloths, obviously. So once you wash the cloths, so to dry those cloths you need to put under the sunshine so that the cloths will be dried up. So similarly for timber and fodder, even for timber means that is the what we call, that is wood basically used to make the furniture. So before making the furniture and to use something, maybe we can call some, to make some gums to attach or to properly make the things, the wetness should not be there in those wood. So what we need to do, so how to take all wetness from the wood, that can be done by the solar energy efficiently. So that's why the solar energy can be used in timber. That means before going to make a wood into a furniture, we need to dry up under the sunshine. That is the timber. Coming to fodder. Fodder means that is a food for all animals. So once the crop was cut from the fields, and that will be exposed to the sunshine. So that will be utilized for the food of the animals, and that food is called fodder. And salt water, to get salt. That means we can take the salt and we can salt water, and we can make as a some arrangements, some small things, and put the salt water. And if you expose the same thing to the sun, that means under sunshine you have done all these things, the water will be evaporated and finally you will get the salt. So to get the salt, this is the one of the procedures. And agriculture products remain or the most extensive use of direct solar sunlight for agriculture products also. So many things we need to make them wet, and we need to make them dried up. And similarly for construction also, we need to do watering for the construction, and once it was done, it has to be dried up. And all these things will be done by the solar energy. Yes, the only one point is very very small point, and that is the biggest point in solar energy, is whenever a body is exposed to sunshine, definitely it will get some temperature. So because of that temperature, and everything will be done. Okay, that is the main concept. So all other devices for harnessing a direct solar energy have fairly the recent origins. So whatever we are using now, to collect the solar energy, those things are the latest inventions only, but previously they have used for these things without having any equipment. Okay, so for direct sunlight only they have done all these things, but now we are doing some other equipments to collect the sunlight and to use it for the some other purposes, maybe solar thermal systems and solar photovoltaic systems. For all these things we need to use solar collectors, so those things are definitely found or invented recently only. So in ancient days they have used only the above two points. So applications, we have already seen some of them, and let us see the other applications also. Yeah, actually he has Archimedes set a Roman fleet on fire by concentrating solar radiation using a large number of small plane mirrors at a distance of several hundreds feet. Actually, by using mirrors, he has identified that we can generate the fire also, and that was identified in 212 BC itself. Okay, if you take a convex lens, you can make the all sun rays fallen on the convex lens concentrated at one point, that is called focal point. And if you concentrate for some time, maybe in a few seconds also, it will generate the fire. Okay, that was invented in 212 BC. So second person, he is Lavoisier, and it is in 1740 to 1794 his area, I mean his time. He has achieved a temperature of 1700 degrees centigrade by concentrating sun's rays. So this was maybe the great achievement by following the previous achievement, and this is also a very great thing. In 1700 degrees centigrade is not a joke, and that was done by simply concentrating the sun's rays itself in 1740 and 1794 itself. Okay, he has done these things. Next, solar steam boilers were invented. They have developed in late 19th century to produce steam to run steam engines. Okay, solar steam boilers. So they have collected the solar energy, they have used it for the boiling of the steam, and finally they have given it to the steam engines, so that they have used the steam engine for automobiles and some other purposes, industrial needs. Okay, that was done in late 19th century. Coming to the other applications, in 1870 a large scale protector using solar energy was installed in Chile. Okay, that is one of the countries in South America, where 6000 gallons of fresh water was produced per day in a desalination plant by collecting solar energy in an area of 50,000 square feet. Okay, desalination plant, that means this is a salt plant, and we need to separate the water and separate the salt. By using solar energy only, they have done the same. Okay, they have done this much, 6000 gallons of fresh water, means that is a huge amount. So that too in 50,000 square feet of land. Okay, this was done in Chile, okay, in 1870 itself. So this was one more milestone in solar energy. In subsequent years, the development of solar energy was declined due to availability of cheap fossil fuels, that means the petrol, coal, all these things were the availability of these things were very more in those days, and that's why the development of solar energy, the research on solar energy was coming down in those days, that means maybe after 1870s, like that. However, after oil crisis in 1973, there is a oil crisis in 1973, solar energy as well as other non-conventional energy sources received renewed interest. That means actually we have interested in all these things because these are the abundant in nature, and they are available every day almost. It may available intermittently also, but there is a scope to get it. But because of cheap fossil fuels, we have, I mean, the human beings have less interest on those things. But still, after 1973, there is an oil crisis. So in those days, definitely they have come back to the all renewable energy sources, including solar energy also. Okay, this is the main things in solar energy. Yeah, thank you so much for listening to this lecture. And if you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video, please share with your friends and family. And if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, kindly do subscribe. I like to cover entire syllabus from my university, JNTU Kakinada, and from this renewable energy sources. And please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any new video. Okay, thank you so much.